So I can't take that responsibility either. But it doesn't take much where something could bad happen.
Can this building withstand a tornado? Have we inspected this building? I mean, if we're gonna put somebody in here, should we inspect it before we make the move? Because I'm pretty sure like everybody in here, it's a foregone conclusion, it's a done deal with moving the hospital to here. And I agree with that, if it's that insane, but we gotta think of things that come along with that, we gotta look forward, we gotta say, that one impacts inspection, we better inspect this one to make sure that it does pass inspection. And then my question about playing ball, I still don't know where we're gonna play ball.
Let me ask this. It's the safety issue. It's not the building, but safety. It's the environment that building is in. If the seismic activity was not happening, that being, or the blast activity was not occurring near an aging building to begin with, then the level of acceptable risk would be as this one is. As Mr. Cooperbaum had shared, a lighting. One of the covering of the lights. Have you ever been in a gymnasium where they fell? Sure they did, at least not. What is the acceptable level of risk for you to be here tonight? What's the acceptable level of risk to drive home? There are always levels of acceptable risk. What level are we willing to assume? And I think the circumstances would dictate that we seriously consider the level of risk that we assume by having our community or our children in a building that is, one, susceptible because it's susceptible to safety compromise simply because of the age and deterioration of the building, compounded by the very close proximity of blasting activity. I think that's what that raises the level of our concern when it comes to the safety of our kids. And as far as the athletics, very important. Very important. Athletics is a extracurricular activity that keeps kids engaged and involved in the educational process. Whether it's an athletic activity as an extracurricular activity, or whether it's an academic extracurricular activity. Whether it is a summer program for kids, for basketball, football, baseball, academics, ballet, whatever it is. The more kids are involved and engaged in education, whatever hook within reason that it takes to keep them involved, to keep them engaged, keep them interested in education as they go through on to graduation, we are going to do that for Martin County. As far as the effect upon our athletics, I think one of the centerpieces of any district, or most districts, in competitive athletics is probably basketball program. Basketball, football, baseball, the other sports are just as important for those who are competing in them. But Coach Smith is certainly here to kind of address the issue.
First of all, nothing's 100% yet. I've discussed it with Coach Rice. Robin Newsom has done a great job of communicating with the Texas High School Association. The issue with basketball is obviously the facility. Just coming in, Robin's been working her rear end off trying to stay in communication with the Kentucky High School Association. It's feasible, and they've given us permission, is that correct, Robin? To use Warfield is 82.2 feet long and regulation is 84 feet. So they've given us permission to use Warfield this year as a home game for the men's and women's basketball. Now we know there's going to be some issues with when we play Johnson Central. How are we going to get after 400 or 500 fans and we're going to turn around and turn away the other 1,000? Well, we'll make exceptions for those. We'll work with those schools. Possibly we play it at the expo. Maybe we move it and play it at another gym. We know that it's not going to be optimal for everything to be perfect this year, but we will have to adapt and overcome. Our women's program had great success. Our men's program did okay last year. And we think that with this, we just found out coming into the board today, we will be allowed to play at Warfield. Now, people are going to say, well, I'm going to close my eyes. And this is just my opinion. That's our bench right there. That first row we put is our bench here. At Warfield, there's about a 6 to 8 feet separation from the sideline to the first row, so we can put a bench here for us, a bench for the visiting team, and then a scorer's table in the middle. So it can be done. Depending on the Kentucky High School Association gives us permission. Now, plan moving forward, we'll have to see how that'll be next year. Hopefully we'll have a new facility, and we can host the districts next year back at home. It involves a lot. You know, I mean, it involves a lot. But I'm kind of, let's go ahead and go forward then. But my point would be, we're going to be sold out of the game. Gym's going to be packed. So let's not lose any basketball. We lost one at home last year. We're not going to lose any at home this year. Got it, guys? Got it? All right. So, and in that situation, we'll have to make do. And we can. And we can. All right? I know you also brought up the cops and about the fiscal, or the fiscal crisis that we're in. I am confident. I'm confident. I really am. I'm confident that we're going to be able to turn this around. Our fiscal challenges that we have before us. I know that a lot of people have been affected by the current fiscal challenges that we have in our school district. But I honestly say that I'm confident that we're going to be able to turn this around. I really believe that. How? I invite you to come down to the central office, meet with me, and I will be happy to put that on the table. I'm not going to be able to solve everything, but I can assure you that we're working hard every day, tighten our belts, wherever we can, for what's best for students. We want to get the funds. Show me the money, right? If I want to know what the priorities are, in your life, if I want to know what's important to you, all I need to do is look at your checkbook. Wherever you spend your money is what's important to you. Now, you can prove me if you want wrong. If you go to your checkbook, you go to your bank reconciliation, and I guarantee you it will reflect what is important in your life. What is important in Walmart? Who said Walmart? You're registered Walmart. But when it comes to the fiscal tightening of our budget, it doesn't necessarily that we certainly the last people that are going to be suffering from that are going to be our students. And the number one job for this guy is to get our students with the most highly qualified teacher that we can possibly get. It's an entire community, and the fact is that the kids don't get a walk from, by the way, I just got off of a bus that took me out to Poplar, I don't know, it looked like a bike trail that somebody had blacktop. And I was breathing the meals when I got back, so I'm still feeling a little loose. And I want to share something with you here. My appreciation for what school did. If it wasn't for people like Coach Ronnie Bass, and you don't know this people, Coach Gary Raymond, Coach Miller, if it wasn't for people like that in my life who came on the other side of the tracks and picked up a little 14, 15-year-old kid who could not get to the school, who did not have transportation, who did not have anybody come and get him at 2 o'clock in the morning after taking a 3-hour bus drive or a football game. If it wasn't for people like that in my life, and you're the same way with your students, if it wasn't for people like that in my life, I probably wouldn't be where I am today. So what athletics, academics, all that brings to our student success, all are important. But the number one priority for our spending is for instruction. It's for the teacher in the classroom. That's what's important. That's what is important to me. It will remain important to me. That's the focus of where we spend our money, because that's the most important thing. Thank you.
Yeah, I've got two. I agree with Jason. I've got a daughter that plays work. My boys play baseball, basketball court. Another question. What all the codes they're expecting to do? I work coal mines. There are 300 men in front of where I work at. Every time I go to Martin County, we got three gyms built. Nine in the four fields of the city. Why didn't we think about this 5 years ago to the high school? Why didn't we stop the last?
Again, very good question. Did not hear us. We built schools in the community over the last several years. Why have we never someone in need? You're absolutely correct. Because let me go back to when I first got here, one of the first documents I looked at was the available instructional space per student. It is astronomical. The state standards now are about 124 square feet per student. In your district, with all your schools combined, including Shelby Clark High School, you're around 200 to 210 per square feet per student. What's that tell you? We got too much facility and not enough students. For the last 10 years, the population has declined for Martin County. For the last 10 years, especially the last 5 years, your daily attendance, meaning your student enrollment, has declined. There has not been an uptick for 10 years. I think the last little bump in that trend was when the penitentiary was built up here on Highway 3. Outside of that little uptick in enrollment, and population growth, for 13 years, it has continued to go down. 14 years ago, you had over 3,000 students in this district. You needed all of this space. And Martin County is not unique when it comes to that. Population is not on the incline, it's on the decline in this nation. And so we're finding that we've got too much facility space for our students, and it's cost a whole lot of money. It stops a whole lot of money. And right now, I'm really the opportunity to take advantage of that.
What do you think it's going to cost the parents to drive a kid to school? And that's not all we're going to have to look at. And gas for all we got.
The cost for transport is about the money. All I'm going to say is that we provide transportation. I'm sure there are exceptions, but we have the bus. Your kid can't get to school, you can't bring them, and you're working two jobs. By the time you get home at night, you can barely open your eyes open, even fix supper, much less help your kid with homework, and you have to worry about gas to get your kid to school, as we all have, and some do. We'll come get your kid on that big yellow limousine.